David Des Roches. He is an associate professor at Near East South Asia Center at the National Defense University and joins us live now from Washington, D.C. Good to speak with you again, David. So just remind us then, why is this happening and why is it happening now? Why have these opposition forces managed to gain so much territory in Syria in such a short time at this particular time?
Yeah, good question. So it's primarily because the Syrian army under Bashar al-Assad is extremely weak and has always been extremely weak. So at the time of the Arab Spring, when there was an insurrection that originally started in Deraa on the south, the Syrian Arab army proved to be effective at bombing hospitals and civilians. But the real fighting to keep them in power was done by Iranian-directed and officered militias that were recruited in Iraq, Pakistan, Afghanistan, by Lebanese Hezbollah, and with air support provided by the Russian armed forces. Well, Lebanese Hezbollah is out of the fight. Russia is preoccupied with the war in Ukraine, and Iran is on the back foot. So they're just unable to commit the kind of forces. And so what you've seen is all that's left on the ground is the Syrian regime, which really has focused on producing and marketing Captagon and shaking down passengers on roads for bribes rather than secure. So it's not to be unexpected that absent their foreign patrons, the Syrian regime would be extremely weak, as it's been seen to be.
And how are they likely to respond at this point? I mean, they have said that they pulled out of Hama for strategic reasons to reduce the loss of life. But long term, how do they hope or expect to get back the territory that they've lost, and how do they plan to do that?
Yeah, so there's two things. So first off, they renewed their campaign of bombing hospitals in Idlib province, which is where the rebels have originated and spread south from. And, it's lost in the approbation of Israel, but the Bashar al-Assad regime has deliberately been targeting civilian infrastructure, particularly hospitals, for over a decade now. The second thing is, I think they're hoping that the rebels will overextend themselves, that they'll seize more land than they can be expected to hold reasonably, and that either the Syrian forces will discover some fighting spirit, which quite frankly has been lacking, or that Russia and Iran will come to their rescue yet again. There is some indication that Russia has sent troops from the Africa Corps, which is the successor to the Wagner mercenary operation in Africa, into Syria. But I think that Russia will be unable to commit sizable combat forces as they did previously. And it looks as though Iran is having difficulty. They have dispatched some of their subordinate militias in Iraq there, but they have been met with opposition by the United States and by the Syrian Democratic Forces in the northeast of the country. So right now, I think their only hope is that the rebels overextend themselves and that they're able to launch an effective counterattack.
All right, good to get your analysis on this. As always, David Des Roches, thanks very much for being with us.
Thank you.